Now, so far that we have learned in our tutorial, we are now aware of how to bring on some carousel sliders from the Materialize CSS website and use them into our project. But still now we are miles away of creating the proper or implementing the proper carousel slider into our project. As an instance, so far the slider that we are using, actually instead of a full width slider, it is using this individual sort of slider. This is the style of it. All it is doing here, it is practically using the defined width and height of the image that we are using currently right now. But this is not the true manner. We haven't used any kind of full width slider properties here. We haven't initialized any kind of full width carousel right over here. So here it is. This is the full width carousel slider initialization. All we need to do, we need to copy this one from here. Just copy it, get back to your project, and instead of this one, we are going to implement it here. So here it is so far. Now if we press Ctrl S and get back to our project and below, we will see that this is the actual scenario. And in this respect, I'd like to see that this varying size of images, it is practically making all those differences. It is now getting more than the full device height over here. And this is what we need to check on. But first of all, let's bring on some indicators here. In order to do so, the second thing that we are going to do, we are going to put a comma here and we are going to make use of this instruction, indicators true. Now if we press Ctrl S and get back to our project and reload, and now we will see that here are some indicators. Those are right now in action. Now here is the limitation of using image source into our project. Moreover, it is much more tricky to implement this sort of thing over here, as if we want to overlay another div or block element on this carousel slider, then we need to make some added manipulation, some CSS tricky manipulations out there, which could be way tricky and which could be way complicated. To avoid that, that is why we will be getting back to our project, and instead of using an image source into the carousel slider that we are using, we are now about to use some kind of background image. And what is the advantage of using a background image? First of all, I do not need to manipulate the image itself. Manipulation of images includes some third-party graphics software, those you may not use into your project. And the second thing is, all of them should be defined into a definite width and height, for say as low as 1280 pixels to 720 pixels. But this is not the exact same case that could be seen in each and every cases. We may not be inclined to use these kind of things over here. So what is the additional thing that we can do in this particular case? If we bring on our images as a background image source, then we can implement the syntax background size cover, and we can set the height of the block element as it satisfies or manifests our project. As an example, if we set the height of the block element to 900 pixels for say, then we do not need to manipulate our images every time into a certain height of 900 pixels. Instead, we can use the syntax of background size cover, and in that essence, the whole image will be fitting into that individual block level element. So this is the advantage of using background image instead of an image source. And as I have specified earlier, that it is much more tricky to suppress your image elements and write something on it. Instead that, we can go through with this block level element, and we can create some parent-child relationship if we want to create. So that is why we will be getting back to our project, and here, first of all, this is the carousel slider that we are using into our project, and we can see that all of them are practically using an image source instead of a background image. So instead of using this image source into our project, if we bring on our images as a background image, Then there's another way to implement carousel slider into your project. And here it goes. Just get down and you can see that this is another option where you can use a particular individual block level element, where you can use your own separate button, or you can use a header tag, you can use a paragraph tag, anything that you want, and you can use all those indicators as been seen over here. So this is practically the code which will be bringing on all of these things into your project. So the very first case that we are going to do, we are going to use this individual code here, copy it, get back into your project, and here instead of using this one, we will be now using this individual code that we have copied from the Materialize CSS website. And here, instead of this kind of initialization, let's see what kind of initialization is being specified over there. There it goes. You can initialize this particular carousel slider into your project with the jQuery, and this is what exactly we are going to do. So we are going to copy this one, and here we will be pasting it. There it goes. We can see that the same thing will be happening over here. This is the full width, that means our image, all those background images into that individual particular carousel slider, that will be full width in nature. That means it will be occupying this whole device width, and it will be having some sort of indicators out there. So this is up to it. Press Ctrl S and get back to your project. Now reload, and you can see that this is the result so far. So here it goes. This is the second carousel slider panel. This is the third one. This is the fourth one. So all of them are right over here.